Hi guys, in this tutorial today I'm going to show you how to create your table, and then you are going to using primary key. So what does mean primary key? Primary key is a unique number that you can identify to one column to another column. So that meaning primary key. So let's go to draw our table. So our customer table got this one, guys, this one, our customer tables. We are going to drop table customers, and then we are going to create another new table, right? Come to here, drop table customers, and then we are going to create a new table. Our table is called again customers. So guys, if you are new here, welcome to Programming Academic, and then after this course you are going to learn so many things. So this is the full stack for data science and data engineering course. After this course, you're going to find your best dreams job in high-tech companies. Wherever you want, you're going to find. So I'm here to help you. You're going to learn everything you want about the SQL language, about the database, about everything you want. You're going to learn with this Programming Academic channel. Always, you're going to learn new tutorials, new high-tech programming technologies. So let's come to here in a great table customers, and then so ID worker 50, and also guys you can just say integer, so it's a whole number that you can use it. And okay, and also you say not null, but in not null we use something else. So in that I don't want to confuse you, but let's do use worker we just say 50. Okay, leave it like this. So this is the ID and the first name and last name and an age, integer number, whole number. And we have a city worker 50, and we have used the primary key. Here is our primary key we used here. So it's, we said we identify to one column to another column, right? So we already, let's go to run and then come to here, because guys, you see it's my column, it's already exists. So let's go to check if our column is exist. Select star from customer, job guys. So EID, first name, last name, and age and city. So there is a, in this column there is a nothing, right? So now we are going to insert new report, right, or new customers, right? So let's go to put here. Yeah. So we are over here, insert. Okay, so insert into customers, we come to ID, and then we say first name, we have a last name, and we have a age and city, right? So this way we use ID and first name and last name and age and city, right? So let's go to give value. Say So we are going to give guys the first ID, so one, right? And then we'll comma. So this is the ID number. This is my own ID number, right? So because I want to know this first ID for who, I already know because I want to use my own ID, right? Okay, ID, and then first name is who, first name, a name is with a string, right? Let's to give a string, we say Adam. Adam, and then last name. Let's say last name, we say it, Usman. Usman. And say 820. And city, we use, let's say it, we take new. York. So now guys, we are going to insert a new, and this one, let's go to change. Okay, always guys use okay. Okay, first name and ID. Okay. So let's go to insert this. Okay. See how to guys here, because we want to insert, right? Insert in into custom. See now, okay, everything looks perfect. Let's go to insert these two, because guys, always to remember to change, because we already used the ID. So this one you can change, because we want to I just specific one to this ID number for Adam, and then for ID 2 for Susan, because like this one. But in another way, that default you can use whatever you want, right? So let's go to insert this two. Okay. Where we are. Okay. Here. Yes. Look guys, we have Adam, man, 20 years, from New York, Susan, Adam, 30 years old. He's from Canada, you see. So in this way you go to insert so many. Let's go to look, just copy this one. Let's copy this one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 times. So what we do, we go back here. Okay, this 3, we just saved ID number 3. Four. Five. Okay, five. We just say 6, 7. Okay. come to here to make a nice job after cleaning your code or organize your code, look nice, right? Okay, so now just go back. So one row is affected, select it. See, one row. So we want to enter this hole until here. So there's some rows, guys. See, it's duplicated. So why? Because we have it here, we change the names, we not change anything, right? So let's go to this item. Small is the okay, so Zan is number 2, and item search from Canada. Okay, so let's go to this one. We want to change number, so then just say Sarah, and we say it 40. Okay, from we just said from chart and for say result from and just we see it to one can't city name which is said Jamal, let's leave it at 70, leave for Canada. Who else? We just say you okay. So let's go to select again to insert. Okay, customer primary in where is duplicating? So the one is okay, it's 111. So new. What we duplicated. Everything is fine. Okay, let's go to run. Okay, just say lost. Okay, 1, 2, 1 and 2 and 6. Is already so last two run 7. Okay, last to run 1 by 1. Okay, 6 is already inserted, right? 6 is already. Now it's fine. Look, guys, see from 1 to 6. So this way, guys, how to create your to become a data science. To become a data engineer. So guys, always when you got an error, so always you learning new things. Because why I guys let you like this, because you are ready to understanding what we are doing, right? If we not make any mistake, you not learn anything, because why you are always to learning from the mistake, right? So that way I'm just to giving you to how to become a data science, how to code. It is a very important to how to code or how to fix in the problems, how to clean your code, right? So you see why we make a duplicate and then we just change in the primary key and then so we play and then we already answered, right? So this way you are going to become a data science and data engineers. Looking forward to see you in my next video. Bye for now.